by his Spirit, raising up every individual, every person who comes into this room and who is a member of our church and who has been coming for a long time. He is lifting up every single one of us. That is amazing. That is absolutely amazing. And so you, I hope today, as we talk a little bit, make sure you take that up. Make sure you realize how important you are to the body of Christ and how important what you bring is to the body of Christ. So if you can stay with me for about 15 minutes here about that, and I really mean it, you know, and the elders' leadership, because, you know, underneath it all is the love of God. How he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. The scripture that I wanted to look at was Hebrews 10, verses 24 and 25. And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works. Not neglecting meeting together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another. And all the more as you see the day drawing near. Encourage one another. We're all in this together. So, important document. Keep it in front of you. We're assimilating all this new information. We're absorbing it. Thinking about my African violets. I'll just brag a little bit. African violets like me, and I like them. And it's just going really well, really, really well. But when you water them, when they get dry, the water goes quickly through, and then the plant sits in it and absorbs the water within several hours. If your African violets are not doing well, that could be why. That's just a little service announcement there. So that's what we're doing. We don't remember everything that was just preached to us over the last 2 months. I don't. You have to keep it in front of you, looking at it and asking God, where's my part? What do I need to do, Lord? Being open to him. So I'm going to give a brief review of my thoughts on the first core value, which is receiving and offering God's grace abundantly. Now, these are lofty values, aren't they? These are lofty. And but we're on this, we're together and we're moving forward together. And I thought about receiving and, you know, offering grace and just my own heart. You know, I want God to reveal my own heart to me. I can blindly go on, not even being aware of what I'm saying, what I'm doing. I can just keep going, but I don't want that. I want God to show me my heart. Because he's not showing me my heart because he's mad. He loves me. And he's saying, Barb, look, he's very, very gentle. So that's the first thing we need to do is to decide, I want God to show me my heart. So just to use a very simple example, I was at Panera's. I like Panera's, little commercial. And I was waiting in line, and it was a Saturday or a Sunday. It was really, really packed, really packed. It was very busy. The line behind me was long, and I finally made it up to the front. And all of a sudden, this woman comes from the side, and she comes over, and she stands in front of me. And inside, I'm going, because I was next. And so now I'm like, don't let your face look like what you're thinking. Try to just keep a bland face. You're out in public. You know, you belong to a church where someone might know you. So I was like stone. My face was like stone, you know. And she went up and finished, and then I'm like, do not make, just walk up gently, do not make any faces. And I survived. I don't think I embarrassed anyone. But you know what? I saw my heart in that. I mean, for crying out loud. What did I miss? 3 minutes of being waited on? I'm like, Barb. And it makes me laugh, and God, I like when he does those revelations that are still funny. So then I get out on the road. It's a Saturday. There's a lot of traffic, and I have another place I want to go. So I get up to the red light, and I stop, and I'm doing really well. I'm happy, you know, and the sun was out then. Remember that, the sun? And all of a sudden, the light turns green, and nobody moves. Have you ever noticed that hesitation? And I'm like, it's green, it's green. And so I want to get going. So I see myself, we have, in my family, we just use an arm thing that we do. We don't do anything else when we're upset. And I'm going, and like the message in the hand is like, I can't believe you can't even drive. It's a green light, for crying out loud. Why don't you just move? And that's when God really revealed my heart. I'm going, wow. Now, that's not a major issue. There are other issues, of course, that are much more serious. But it gave me a glimpse. I think I lost 5 seconds there. Really. So I'm one of them. I'm sure there's other people here. There's got to be somebody else that God likes to talk to you about your Christian views while you're driving the car. And so receiving grace, whew, I needed to receive his grace. I need to offer grace. You know what? I didn't get caught, but I didn't offer grace to the lady that moved in front of me. I didn't offer grace. That was an opportunity. And I'll have many more. But that's an opportunity that I missed. I could have turned to the side, smiled, you know, let her go. Although the people behind me probably would have had a problem with it. But he's extending grace to us, and we need to extend grace to one another. Don't be afraid to be aware of what's in your mind, what you're thinking, and your emotions. This is because I'm talking about where is our realness in being a Christian. That's my realness. And God revealed himself to me, and I said, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Because he so sweetly said, look what you're doing. You know? So, always offering grace and always receiving grace. And again, one of the themes here is, if another person doesn't offer me grace, well, I still need to offer grace to them. And for some, that's where the rubber meets the road. So let's look a little bit at core value number two. We value and respect all people equally. Like I said, these are big. All people equally. So that means that we're all equally valuing one another, like even in this room today. So we're all, it's not like it's for some people, it's for all people. We value and respect all people. And each one of us takes responsibility for that. I could look at someone else and wonder why they're not doing the right thing. But am I doing the right thing? I got to look at me. I got to let God show me my heart. And you know, we're not waiting to be respected and valued. We're not sitting back, you know, kicking back, staring out at other people, watching them. You know, how are they doing? How are they not doing? No, we're not waiting for that. We're not waiting to feel someone respect us. We're not waiting for someone else to look at us and show us respect. We're doing it first. And we're not living with, well, you know, I'm sorry, I just don't like that person. And until they show me some respect, I'm not going to show any respect to them. Now, I said that so well. Isn't that scary? Because that's what goes through my head. Wow. All right, this is my last day as an elder here. But isn't that what we do? Not consciously. That's why you have to let God reveal your heart. Because it's not a conscious thing. It's a well-oiled response. It's a well-oiled thinking pattern that we just slip right into. We don't even know it. And that's why I'm saying, Lord, please. I'm not afraid to pray, show me my heart. Because he's not condemning. He's not condemning us. And he's not condemning me. It's our love relationship we have with God that he's willing to do that so sweetly. How are we doing, okay? It's a little different skew, which I love doing, but it's terrifying. Okay, the next one is we stay at the table. And what I say about stay at the table is it's the easiest one to remember. When I'm up here and Pastor Tracy's going through and I'm going to blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. Stay at the table. You know, stay at the table. It's like so clear, and I understand what that means. So it's hard to walk out. But, you know, the concept of staying at the table, staying open to one another, having conversations with one another, I thought about this week, that minimizes the fractures in the church body, in the community. You know, you have a community with each other. Things always, you know, there's always things that are misunderstood. But if we, or as we, no ifs, as we continue on together, as each one of us being a part of this change, then there will be less fracturing in the body of Christ. I like that image. I like that imagery. But guess what? How about what happens before you get to the table? Oh. Because there's things that we can do. They're relational. They're communication things, you know. And I made up a word, I think. I don't know. Somebody will have to check. But I'm trying to be serious here. Mishearing. Mishearing. Because, you know, we mishear what we've heard someone say to us or we've heard them say to someone else. We miss the intent of the comment. We miss the meaning of the comment. And we hear part of it. And we take that part we heard and we say it to somebody else or we say it to ourselves and we pass it on like it's truth. It may not be truth. I mean, you know, when you see one another and we gather together on a Sunday and, you know, you see have interactions with people, you don't even know what that person is dealing with. You don't even know. I mean, we look and we judge by the outward, but many and most people are struggling with some type of loss, something that's not going well. And so we have to be careful, you know? Mishearing. We take the misunderstood. I'm reading it like it's really in the dictionary or something, but it's not. So we look out and we have grids. We all have experiences. We all have things we've internalized, how things have affected us, what we think is right, what we think is wrong. We all have them. They're all different. I'm glad God's God. Because that's a huge puzzle, you know? But God can do it. And we misunderstand. And it would be better if we could stop and ask God to show us our own heart, pray about it a little bit, and most of the time, let it go. Well, maybe there's some things that we can't let go. So then you proceed. You get, you know, maybe one of the leaders to intervene or have a conversation or see a counselor or, you know, whatever, to deal with what you heard, decide if it's truth or not, and sometimes let it go. Let it go. So before we get to the table, as we live together as brother and sisters, let's be aware of our hearing. and what we hear. And I know it's hard for us when we're right and someone else is wrong. It's just really, because there's only one right. There's a lot of wrongs, but my right is right. And so we have to not be afraid to talk to one another with respect. And consider the fact that, well, what I heard isn't really what they meant. It wasn't their meaning. It wasn't their intent. I only heard half of what they said. So yes, stay at the table. I love the imagery of that. And that is one of the most powerful core values that we have. And then also now, there's things we can do before that. Before grumbling around, you know, month after month after month after month and letting it build into something that's really not truth anymore. So, does that make sense? You heard it first here, mishearing. Oh boy. Okay, so check out your own heart and continue to invite God in to that, to revealing that to you, revealing your heart. Okay, I'm on the last two. I put two together because I think they kind of contain something that's similar, at least in my thinking. The core value is we embrace learning and discovery, which is so lovable about our community. It's just so fun. And we multiply leaders. And both of these core points require us to keep an open mind about our own potential. I don't know what got me thinking about this, you know, but when you're being drawn into new discoveries and new learning, and when you see people in leadership in the church or people gaining jobs of importance or something, there's this voice that starts to speak that says, well, I can't do that. I can't do that. I'm not old enough, I'm not young enough, I'm not smart enough, I can't do that. And this thought starts to come and we take hold of it. Oh, I can't do that. No, I could never take that class. I would never make it through foundations. I can't, you know, preach because it's too scary to preach. I don't know enough. I can't remember. I can't work with the children because I've never worked with children before and I don't really. Come on, you guys have to know that little voice that says you can't. You can't, you can't, you can't, you can't. They can. Wow, look at all the gifts they have over there, you know. But you can't, and we have to stop that. We have to stop it. I mean, if you think of your potential in Christ, I think it's unlimited. Right? Our potential is amazing. We don't even know the jewels that live inside of us. We don't even know because we haven't been encouraged and we've been made fun of and we're just afraid to take a step out. And we just have to stop it. So awareness is knowing what you're thinking. Awareness is knowing what's in your heart. And as soon as you hear anything about how you can't do anything, don't even try, no, people are going to laugh at you. When you hear that, you have to stop it. And if you have a prayer partner or someone you can talk to, you need to tell them too. This is what I'm thinking. I really want to try out for the Christmas chorus, but I'll never be able to do it. I know I won't be able to do it, you know? And so you just sit back and the day of the chorus, you're like, sad and angry, and you know, you could have given it a shot. You could have sorry, Joni. You could have said something to Joni, and she could have said, "Oh, we closed that, you know, 2 weeks ago." And you say, "Oh, okay, well, next year maybe I'll do it." Or you know, she could say, "All right, well, let's give it a try." This is just this isn't official, but it's in the thought of. Just try. Don't let that's what I heard today, you know, about promises. Promises that God has given you, do not let the enemy steal from you. God gave it to you. It's not working out the way you thought. You know God always does that. He gives you a quick miracle, or he has you do it day-to-day, breath-by-breath. You know that's what he does. But he always does something. He's a good, good father. So we embrace learning and discovery, and we multiply leaders, and that's for all of us. It applies to all of us. So once again, let God reveal your heart to you. And that's what I have to say. Because, you know, for us, we know there's still more. It's not like you come to the end of the day and, oh, well, that was it. It wasn't a good day. There's still more. With God, there's still more. You're all a part of the steps that we're taking here as a community. All. Every single person. And God's love is what's under that. Because God loves all of us. He totally knows what we're like, who we are. But he totally loves all of us. And you know, when we sang that today, I'm like, that's the only reason why I can stand up and like speak and like try to be, not try to be funny. It's just, I don't know what it is, but that's why, because I know I'm loved, you know? And if anything we do doesn't work out the way we hope, it doesn't mean we're not loved. We're always loved. And, so there's great hope for us today. And so let's consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another. Encouraging one another. And we have such an amazing group of people here at Cornerstone. It's just absolutely amazing. We prayed in a small circle this morning, and different voices from different nations. It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing what God's doing. So don't be afraid. Do not put this in a drawer. Well, you could if you want to find it again, I guess. Some people might need it in a drawer. But be active. Be actively thinking about what the church is founded on and where we're going and how you are a part of it. And one part isn't any more important than another. That would be that voice again, wouldn't it? Well, I'm not really important here. You know, I'm not really, I couldn't do what they're doing. I'm like, stop it. And speak truth. I can do all things through Christ. I can do all things through Christ. He is for me. He is good. Take the scriptures, shout them out, because that's the truth. He made you a promise, he'll bring it to pass. So we're going to transition from here to communion together, which I think is really beautiful, with our new members that we took in today, and just take this. You know, I think basically the challenge from me to you is, stay invested in what we're doing here and don't give up, and let God show your heart to you and take his direction. He knows it all. So I have to find my little thing here. Now I'm going to just talk for a few minutes. I think I'm doing really well with time here. Are we doing well, everybody? So this is an opportunity for sacrament of communion. We take it together as a community, as a body, knowing that our unity is growing and that God has shown us that he has more for us than we ever thought he did, the way he's just breathing life into our community is absolutely amazing. But it's not the most amazing thing is that he came to earth and he gave up his life. He sacrificed for us. He sacrificed his life for us. And in a not in an easy way, in a torturous way. And he did that so that we could all receive his love without debt. Our debts have been paid. Oh, we don't have to carry them around with us anymore. And if you just take a little bit of time this morning before we begin communion, think about what he's done for us. Think about his sacrifice. Think about where you are today, what he's revealed to your heart, you know, this morning or this week, an opportunity for you to ask him to forgive you. It's such a painless path that God has given us. It's absolutely amazing. But to ask his forgiveness is right and powerful. So let's just take a moment quietly with each other and just check your heart. Let the Lord check your heart. Lord, I thank you for my brothers and sisters this morning. And we pray for new and fresh revelations of what it means to be your children, what it means to be community together. Help us, Lord. Help us to love one another the way you've shown us. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body." Will the servers come up, please? I don't mean to not be reverent, but someone walked away with my notes of the scripture, so. And I'll just do a commercial because I know that God laughs. Thank you, Lord. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Let the musicians come up first. And anyone else that's working on techie things. We're going to come down through the two aisles and then walk back around. The aisles on near the wall are wider, just so you know, for walking through. All right, let's receive. Come on up.
Thank you. just want to take a moment and reflect back to Carol's word. Just drink in the Father's presence, the Spirit's presence, the presence of the living Jesus Christ. We want to honor our new members, including those that had difficulty getting here on time today, because this world is difficult. So this might feel a little out of place in our service, but we'd like to ask Sarah Walls to come forward with one of our new members who was not able to come early. Hope.
Thank you, Hope. You want to join me up here? Hope has been coming here for a while anyway, so we'd just like to introduce you to the congregation. The congregation to Hope, when it gives us your name and just how you come to be here.
Okay. My name is Hope. Last name is Clary. I've been coming here off and on for maybe a couple years. I actually heard of this church from another member who just recently joined, Carol. We were at another church together. So basically, I live close to this church, so just walked over for a service and kind of kept coming from there on.
Well, we welcome you here, and we know that the Lord has a work for you here, and we're just excited to see where God's going to lead you in this body. So we're going to just have Elder pray.
Father God, we just thank you for Hope. We thank you that her name embodies who you are to us. We thank you, Lord God, for her place in this body. We thank you, Lord, that she brings her gifts willingly to your banquet table for your people to feast on. And we thank you, Lord, that she will be fed. We praise you, Lord God, for adding to our body daily, as the word says. And we thank you, Lord, that not one soul will be lost. Thank you for the harvest. Thank you for the fruit. And thank you that your glory will be manifest in Hope and in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If everybody could stand and please join with me in the benediction. And I'm going to ask you, if you feel so bold, grab the hand of a person next to you. Father God, we just reflect on the word brought forth by Elder Barb. And I just think, Lord, of how staying at the table is so, in particular, is so important, because you are the bread. You are our nourishment. You are our drink. And for some reason, you call us to be the conduit for that. When you encountered Saul before he became Paul, you said, "Why do you persecute me, not my people? Why do you persecute me?" You identify yourself with the person whose hand we're holding and with us. You say, "That is me. That is my body." Lord Jesus Christ, bless us today that we can eat all that you have for us, that we can receive all that you have for us, and that we can also be the conduit for somebody else eating and drinking all that you have for them. We thank you for your presence manifested in the person we are holding right now and in us. We pray, Lord Jesus Christ, bless us that we can be your essence, your fragrance, your aroma in this world. We offer ourselves to you, and we thank you that you call us your own. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Woo!